Welcome back, everyone. Some more Streets of Rage 4 action coming your way. So we've completed the game now across the hardest difficulty with all of the Streets of Rage 4 characters. Now I'm going to be working on Streets of Rage 1 and 2 characters, starting from top left, which will be Blaze, and then we'll work on to Streets of Rage 3 characters after that. And then once I've got through with all of those characters, we're going to then move on to Mania, and then the fun begins, or the swearing begins, maybe, I don't know. But it's going to be quite hard with some of these retro characters to get through it, I think, on Mania. I'm going to need to really have some strategies in place for that. But yeah, let's go. We should be okay, hopefully, with Blaze, Streets of Rage 1. Let's get going. Okay, new game, hardest. Blaze, Streets of Rage 1. So we're not going to have any real special moves with Blaze. Basic attack, jump, and special. That's all we're going to get. So, luckily, the developers gave him quite a bit of power, so that's okay, it's not too bad. Got no defensive special with these guys. You just get special. Alright, let's go. So positioning is going to be quite key with this. Look, they've got quite big hitboxes on the old characters. The knife guys out quite easy. You like that? Throws more. Definitely. Can't be doing that. Ouch. Getting me, Donovan. Okay. Pin that first, then him. Spin it off there. Yep. Definitely need to be making use of invincibility with the throws. Okay. Need to get out of that habit of doing special. Maybe we didn't need to do that then. punish me later on if I keep using my special like that. Yeah, I like the old specials of the police cars, but not very helpful on this, to be fair. Special will be really nice right now. Those guys are much harder with the old characters. What you two been doing today then? Where you been, Craig? My type of weather, yeah? Yeah, indoors, definitely. Oh, go stick a light on one sec. Like your new icons, by the way, like your tails points. Called power points as well. I have to change how I play this game actually, because we don't have any defensive special, so really. All you've got is this road run. Thank you. one advantage you seem to have with the Streets 1 characters is you can take out Barney without him grabbing you. That's quite good. Well, at least with Blaze. She's got long reach. I'm doing this really. Don't get you any extra points. Let's just do it. Should have really gone straight into the commissioner really. Oh well. Never mind. All this for a star and some money. Ah, here it comes. That wasn't worth it. Never mind. I've got a little surprise for you. Looks like he's got surprises as well. Alright, that's not worth. This is where I need to use star power. Take the Barneys out. Or maybe not. Come on, Barney. Give me a break. Uh-oh. This ain't going well. Come on, Barney. We're all friends here. Thank you. walking from nowhere. Yep, no worries, lad. Yeah, he's good, isn't he? Fight like that. Just gives a little bit of something different to the chat as well, rather than just the standard points you get. There you go, you figured out how to use them now. Not really, to be honest, no. I mean, last night I got another game of first. Came first again, we got 1.3 million. So we did pretty well. Yeah, it's a hard game, Warzone. It's very competitive. Very competitive. So many people streaming that game now. It's like 68,000 on it right now, so it's hard to be competitive on that. Yep. There you go. Eat that. Come on. Come to that. Hey Grim, and the gang, how you all doing? You all well? That's awesome, cheers for the follow, buddy. Hey Nent, how's it going? Hey up lad. I like it, I like it. Good old Yorkshire. That deserves a cup of tea in a minute, hang on. I'm getting destroyed by these guys. Come on. Alright, alright. The old back turn. About to take those guys out. Come on. How's everyone doing? You all been watching Grimm's Streets of Rage 4 maybe? Grim? You've been playing something different. Playing a bit of Minecraft. Alright, okay. Good old Minecraft. You know what, that was a game I never really got into, but I should do really. Every time I go to the arcade club, they've always got a Minecraft room up there. I should get a try once. Yeah, I don't know why I'm hitting these guys. There's a wall over there, and they're getting thrown into it. Okay. When did it come out? I kind of lost them. I've kind of lost perception of any other game at the moment, to be honest. I've just been playing the hell out of this. I certainly have silver. I'm a big time fan of that place. I used to go every Saturday until the lockdown. So I will be going back every Saturday again as soon as all this nonsense stops happening. Yeah, I know the owner pretty well of Arcade Club, so I've been going there since it's opened. I was saying actually on one of my last streams, guys, for all my followers, seems to be a lot of guys from the UK following me now around the Yorkshire area, so I'm down for like a special MR Tuna 123 Arcade Club day if you guys all want to meet there. Have a burger and some chips and a pint, play some games, maybe stream live from Arcade Club in Leeds. Fun. We've already got two people on board with it. You guys are all welcome to follow. How long you been playing Minecraft for then? How many hours you been streaming with? Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Take over Arcade Club. Yeah, I know the manager there quite well, so he'll let me use the power as well, so we can actually get a phone on the cradle and go around different machines. We can stream lots of different games. We can go on two-player, four-player games. We've got turtles in there, as you'll probably know, Silver. Sounds like you're a fan of Arcade Club Leeds. And that's the place where I got my very first Donkey Kong kill screen. One of their cabinets in there. You'll probably see my scores on the game if you go up there. Pizzas are really good there as well. They're only a few quid. Coffee's good as well. 2 quid for a coffee. Can't complain. Nice. Local lads, I like to see it. Celebration cup of tea, I think, for that one. Can't beat Yorkshire. Yeah, Geisley's just up the road from me, so I live in Bailden, which is just around the corner. Literally, like, up the road. Come on. Sneaky monkey. Oh, nice. Newcastle, but this is from Leeds. Okay. Well, Newcastle's not too far from Leeds, is it? So next time you're down, definitely do an Arcade Club. So what, we've got Grim, we've got Silver, we've got, I don't think he's here tonight, actually, he's not here yet. JKD Steve, we've got Jay, he's a Leeds lad. So we've got five of us so far, and I reckon if I can convince some of my further away followers to meet us there as well. Play any Tekken? If I'm honest, I used to love Tekken 3 on the PlayStation. It was one of my favourite games, but I wasn't really good at it. I always used to struggle even getting through story mode. I've never really been very good at one-on-one beat 'em ups. I'm pretty good at stuff like this. FPS games, I'm good at Counter-Strike. Pretty decent at Warzone. Mainly platformers. Scrolling beat 'em ups like this is what I like. But yeah, I love Tekken. I'm just not very good at it. I get whooped every time. That's terrible. no need to die there whatsoever. Oh, there, that was horrendous. What am I doing? Tekken 2 was good, but I think 3 was the one for me. Terrible timing. This has gone very bad. Should be really easy, this as well. Oh no. Come on, special. Should not be using special right there, but okay. Really bad position there.
Excuse me, I'd like to ask you a few questions.
I'm sure you would. What, like, why am I playing so trash right now? We'll make it up. I purposely lost a life there. That was done on purpose. So that we can complete it with a deficit. Yep, up to day, boy. How long you been living in Newcastle then? You been there all your life? I never thought I'd say this as well, but I actually prefer the modern music on this game now.
Your shoe is bigger than this car.
I just added that one today. I'm gonna try and add a new one every stream. If any of you lads have this game, by the way, I'm also up for doing co-op. Did you stay there then? Just got to like it and that's on it. Got family near there, friends. Target locked. Backup requested. Yeah, there's not much there. I probably like it, to be fair. I'm a bit of an introvert at times. Oh, that's not good. Come on. Oh yeah, love centre backs. Amazing play. Come on, dirty fire. Backup requested, backup dispatched. Come on, do your silly kick. Sorry, there's not going to be much variation on this game, guys, because as you can tell, I'm using Streets 1 characters, and they don't really have many moves to their arsenal, but oh well. Oh, come on, come on. Don't lock me in this. I was planning on keeping that burger till the end. Oh, they're so dirty when they happen. Okay. At least I've not got a commissioners yet. Oh, they're laughing players. Another one bites the dust. Yeah, I must admit, like any other young person, when you've got naff all to do and your mates are not there and whatever, you want to move somewhere more exciting like London and places that have got lots of places to go. But when you get older, like the ripe age of 34 that I am, then you just start to think, well, you know what, I want a log cabin away from people. I've been enjoying this lockdown. Pretty fine. I like it. Obviously, I don't want to see anyone suffer, etc., the usual stuff, but the actual experience. Less people about. I can go out whenever I want. It's less busy. I like it. How about you guys? How are you guys all doing? What are you thinking of? What's happening at the moment? You cool with it? I've just been twitching a lot. It's great. Yeah, I really enjoy it. I mean, now that the stats are coming out and everyone's realizing that it's a bit of a hoax, this thing as well, you know. But if they want to furlough me and allow me to play Twitch, I'm not bothered. Throw your boots. So everyone that came across from Grimm's chat, what do you guys play? Are you Streets players as well? Minecraft? Fortnite? Warzone? What are you guys into? Streets? Honest, what I found from watching a lot of the pro Streets of Rage 4 guys is that the further you get in the game, so hardest and mania, it becomes about jabbing, which I didn't like doing. It's not my style of play. I like to run around like a madman and just use all my specials, but you can't get past mania without jabs and grouping, and it's just not possible. It's just not possible. And you also need to learn the spawn patterns as well. Once you learn that, you're good. And making use of your invincibility frames, so like, this is probably the best move that Blaze has, because look, he tried to overcut me there. Time her out, wait till she lands. Well, that was a bad example, but look. Throw him just as you're about to get hit, and you get a couple of frames of invince. It's good for crowd control, especially the karate guys that are overpowered. You know those karate guys that block everything and then just destroy you? All you need to do with those guys is move up and down, make use of your vertical motion. Grab one of them face to face and flip them behind you and throw them into each other. That's all you need to do with those guys. Quite simple. I'm by no means one of the best players out there. Obviously, you've got Anthor, you've got Jay Miller, he's a top player, Shin. Those guys are absolutely epic on this game. But I guess there should be the amount of hours to put into it. Have you guys completed any modes? Co-op or single? Like this right here, look. All you want to do is come to the top left corner, keep making use of your jab, time it, group them all, take them all out. Don't put friendly fire on, whatever you do. So when I were playing with me and Jay Miller played a few games co-op, actually, like I say, he's a top guy, and he turned friendly fire on and I kicked the crap out of him the first time by blitzing him and lost all his health. It was quite funny. So you found the funny side of it. But Yeah, we've done a couple of Mania runs. Sometimes I've died and he's had to take me through near the end. But I can hold my own. I can pretty much get there. As long as I select a character I'm good with, I'm okay. This bit, you don't even need to attack these girls. So normally, the first time I play through this game, just move up and down, wait for them to almost kill themselves in that smoke. Hardly need to touch him. First time I played it, I didn't go to the right hand side of these things and got absolutely destroyed. Triple jump him to get your first combo in. Special to keep the bends at bay. Pick up the pipe. No, I missed the pipe actually. Oh well. I'm probably going to take a bit of damage here. To do here is grab one. Bad timing. Okay, make use of my throws. Convince frames. Nope, that didn't work. It's too late. I'm still getting used to Blaze, so I'm not really down with her timing at the moment. It's losing a life there, but okay, we'll take it. Stand in the middle, wait for them all to come down. Yeah, get them all in one go almost. Also, turn your back from them, then at the last second attack. They won't do the jumping attack when your back's to them like this, watch. And just turn around and attack them. So when you're on the 2D bits, those jumpy guys, just turn your back away from them. Wait till they run right up to you, get right behind your back. Either do a back kick like that, or turn around and go into your combos. Makes it a lot easier. These guys turn your back again, wait for the come, keep them into a jab, three jabs, then go into your special, and you'll hit them out the first time. So this bit's all about all about your throws. So bait one of them in, go face to face, throw, bait one in, last second, face to face. Oh, see that's the problem right there. Now she's going to get too close. And that's going to happen. Face to face. There we go. Yeah. It's going a bit messy here. Bait one in. Let her turn around. Face to face. Then throw. Just as the other one's about to fly. Oh. There. Again. And you're doing damage as well at the same time. Face to face. Throw. Next one in. Come on. Hardly taking the damage, if any, the apple. They really caught me out of those. When I first played, I was going to say a naughty word then. Okay, he's got long reach here, so just use your up and down. Oh, I hit the bottom of the screen there. Yeah, just use your up and down, wait for the screen to take it off him. That 8 ball does some serious damage, so I say bait this guy in, try and take out guys one at a time, sort of tease him onto the screen, deal with less of them at the same time. Okay, wrong way with her, never mind. Okay, come on, come on. Bad timing, unlucky with that one. Table out. There's a reason for that. I'll try and get, once she goes through this chair now, I want to try and get the 8 ball and throw it at her if she cooperates. Nope, he's going to come up first. Oh, that didn't work. The 8 ball does loads of damage, so you want to try and get it on her early. And it's more critical when you're on Mania, to be honest. Oh, that's all she did that. Oh. So he's going to be really annoying. So the yellow ones usually just go horizontally. The red ones go diagonal. Okay, see you on it. Don't bother with the arcade, it gives you more points if you don't go in them. Unless you know you're going to get past them. Alright, we've got the extra anyway. Go for the knife. What do you want me to do, guys? Do you want me to take the backs out or just take them one on one? Have some fun. Cheers. It's definitely a methodical game. So I learnt a lot of my what I know now from a guy called Crab Milk Mickey. He's a really good streets player, really nice guy as well. And you've just got to be really calm about the game. You can't rush anything. It's not like Tekken, you were saying, you know. It's totally different. Like that right there, look. It's just all crowd control. If I'd have split those guys up, it would have been really tricky that bit. And it's about edging forward a bit at a time so that you don't get too many on the screen at once. Guys with the weapons, try and get them to move up and down on the screen so they get them frustrated. Take them out quick. Hold, yep. I knew he was going to uppercut then, so I held that move just slightly so that I could move out of the way of it. Make use of the weapons in this game because they are needed, especially on the later stages. You can't just get through it by kicking the poop out of people. So use that jab to take away half the health bar as well. Okay. bits going. There's going to be quite a lot coming on the screen now, including these guys. Face them. Same again. Same as the biker chicks. Use your... Oh, yeah, this is going nasty right now. I messed up the pattern. Okay. Have a cut. Okay. So face them. Stay still. Wait for them to come in. I faced the wrong way there. Annoyingly. Okay. I'll take that. No problem. Bit in again. So he wasn't going to jump then. So because he closed the distance too much, I just know by feel now that he's not going to do a flying knee. He's going to come straight for me. So again, use your up and down because you can move faster as a Streets of Rage 1 player. You can move faster than all the characters in the game. So just move up or down to the point where he's basically next to your character and jab check him before he can get in line with him. Take that guy out. Don't move too far forward here. Face away. Make use of the weapons. He's not going to fly kick when I'm turning away. Yep, that guy falls straight into me. I knew how he was going to spawn. Okay, if the karate guys block, just grab them. Come from above them and come down onto them and grab them. Okay, always make use of this sign, because you can throw this. Take the first one out. Okay, second one out before she moves. The karate guy is still in place though, you see. Okay, this is where she's gonna have a bit of help. Just move up. Take her out. Whip this guy a knee, which he usually does. Nope, he's coming for me, comes out. Just move, make use of up now and just jab check in, don't pause. Okay, this is where you can just tease one at a time. One. It's easier to deal with one of these guys than two. Jump. That's all you need to do is just move up. Look at him. Move up. Start moving up and he'll always jump, try and get you. Moving down. Usually laughs after his second jump and throw him. And these guys are pretty easy. I say I'm getting to the point now where apart from Skytrain on hardest, the double commissioner, I struggle like hell with that. So you'll probably see that soon, but apart from that bit, I'm getting to the point now where I reckon I can consistently move to Mania now. Like before, it was a bit of a struggle. I always jab check first and make sure they're not going to be invincible. Always make use of these as well. Clear them. Takes the whole line out, turn away. Gonna be aiming for top left corner here. Donovan. Okay, line them up. Chicken should come out, stay top left. Grab the first guy that comes out. Chicken now, never mind. I think I'm just gonna cut me off the screen now. It is. Oh, never mind. We'll do it without it. Throw. Same again, turn away. Throw. Takes two out, usually. We've got low health now, so just chop check on it. Take this guy out without actually bringing the other Big Ben on the screen, so throw this, grab it, keep throwing it at him, wait for him to jump. Okay, turn your back away from him, throw it as soon as he gets up. That's it, he's done. These guys can be tricky. Like now, I got to the wrong side of those guys then. Because that's what you want. And ideally you want them to jump at you with a flying knee so you can counter them with a throw. This guy's just going to blitz across the screen like a lunatic like he always does. Oh yeah, he's going to actually come hit me. Okay. Just use your up and Y, up and down to protect this guy. Wait for him to get into a corner of the screen. Punish him once. Take him straight out then. Okay. These guys are pretty easy, but they just take a little while with someone like this without any special. You can only really throw these guys. Again, those guys, when you get later on in the game, you get four of them. That's when it becomes tricky. But all you need to do is make use of your throws. Get that guy out. Stand on this second line down here. Move across to the right. In they come. I should have got two in one there. That was bad. Try and wait for two to spawn on the screen at once. You want to get a double combo out of that, ideally. Clean sweep.
Yummy!
Take this guy out first because he's the one that spawns more of them in. If you take him out, no more should come in. Yeah. Try and get him out of the way first. This is where things can go really badly wrong here. Have the opportunity to take him out, but alright. We're gonna get more points for it at least. We made it a lot more harder on ourselves, but okay, whatever. Alright, back up to three lives anyway. On to the end boss. If you guys like chatting as well, feel free to join my Discord channel. Links on my stream. A few guys in there that talk quite a bit. Jason Bradbury's in there. Trista's in there. A few other people in there. Cool people to talk to. They've got good streams going on as well. There we go. We made top two, top 1,000 with that one as well. Right. So you say I make this game look easy, but now I'm on the worst stage on the game. As you guys probably already know, this stage needs fixing. I've said it a few times on stream, but it's really annoying. Really ruins the flow of the game. I mean, developers need to fix this commissioner nonsense for him. I'll try and get past it, but I might need a few retries at this. We'll see. Focus on Barney at this point. Don't want any of that. Just trying to get straight off the Barney. Thank you. she's as good as done now with Commissioner Zetlora.
Good.
First time. I'm either learning, or Blaze is a bit easier than I thought. Should we finish off with grenades? Ah, she's dead. Alright. We got her first time. Actually, quite easily as well. I had a bar and a half of health. Huh. I'm on the struggle with Streets of Rage 4 characters on my head. We got a C as well. Okay guys, I just need to pop for a tee-wee. I'll be back in 2 or 3 minutes. Yep, back soon guys.
If I'm not back in 5 minutes, just wait longer.
Okay guys, I'm back. Sorry about the delay there. I had a toilet issue. It wouldn't stop filling up with water.
All right.
Never mind. Hey Grim, thanks for tuning in. Cheers for the raid there. I'll see you next time. See you later, bud. Hope you got something out of the stream. Yeah, so sorry about the delay there. I was on a menu 2 minutes. Standing that, boys. We're gonna try and remember the chicken for the last boss. It lets me get it. Oh, jeez. Cool. Still with us, Mad. How's everyone doing still? Enjoying Blaze? Hold on. seen a bit, Craig. Cheers for dropping in. Getting a chicken in the face now. Oh, maybe not. Oh, that was terrible. I carried the chicken the entire run and then threw it at a box. Oh, lovely. That was way better. Her damage output from the green stuff is less than what you can give her, so just keep smashing it. Let her really go in, just keep hitting it. Doesn't matter, it does nothing. All that does. Just keep smacking her in it. That's the help if you need it from the fire. Should have picked the burger up there. Never mind. Everyone all right in chat? Just watching. Yeah. That was a tricky bit. It can be tricky, but it can also be easy. I'll get the position right here. Oh, messed it up. Recover from it after. Okay, fun bit. Could have done with a glass broken here. After freestyle this bit. Glass broken isn't ideal. This could be a mess right here. Not too bad, considering I didn't take the sides out of there. Alright. Well done, Max. Alright. Doing that again. Alright, first time he's never thrown that hammer, right? And I missed the apple. Jesus, come there. Yeah. Oh, this one tricky from the top. Hmm. Just about a burger. Come on. Close. No way. Invincible, no reason left. Ouch. Oh, that was stupid. Never jump. Never done. Alright, we lost the extra life that we scraped then. We've got 6,000. I think. I'm going to get past this, but it'll be alright. Alright, we made that a lot harder than it needed to be. Let's go! Stage 11. Get in there. Thank you. No. Yep. I'm rubbish. So bad. Not having you today. Yep. Unlocked, brilliant. Oh. Okay. Extra large of 2,000, we should be alright. Right, I need to run forward. Like Blaze's jump. There was a lot of ground for that. Two rocket launchers, really. Another one bites the dust. Just enough tea left. Thank you. defense is special, that might work. Huh. I could have sworn it was there where you hit her. Was it? Oh, whatever. Alright. Just pull me out of defensive special, I don't know. Wrong way. Oh god. This is why you don't attack them. Keep them space to bark. Really? Really?
That was my bad. I didn't jump out of it in time, really.
I actually find that shit a lot harder on hardest. Get two of those. Let the silliness begin. We got through the whole game with Blaze, no death run. Not bad. She's pretty good. It's kind of easy to get used to Blaze, though. She's not really got many moves, to be fair. I knew a back throw would be really powerful through all of this. Alright, let's go. I'm a boss. All right, let's go. Oh yeah, I know, I got this. Easy peasy. No death run with Blaze. Perfect. Why not? I missed her! What the hell? No problem. Appreciate the spot. Yeah, no worries. I sometimes watch it from the couch as well, rather than sitting on a PC. Depends what mood I'm in. Whether I'm in a chatty mood or not. Alright. I mean, that was pretty easy to be honest. I had no clear... I had no issues through that run at all. That could have been an arcade run, I think. Alright, so it looks like my highest score was with Blaze. It would have been quicker as well if I'd have kept them there for life. I reckon I could have just dipped into the top, into the top 1000, right? Yeah, I reckon so. Right, well that's going to call it for tonight's stream. Thanks everyone for tuning in. So we got through it with Blaze SoR1, no death. Quite straightforward. I think Axel's going to be quite easy. He's meant to be quite good Streets of Rage 1. Depends on what his throws like. I like good throws with my characters. To keep them spread apart. Cheers, bud. Yeah. To be honest, I actually found Blaze SoR1 easier than Blaze. I just streamed straight through that. I reckon I could hit Mania with Blaze SoR1 and be okay, to be honest. I think the next one is Axel, I believe. So we're going for him now. Oh, I think actually no, it's Adam from left to right. Correct me if I'm wrong, Mad. Is it Blaze, then Adam, then Axel for SO1 characters? Can't remember. Nah. I'll just go in here and have a quick look. Hang on. Yeah, so we've done Blaze. We're going to be moving to Adam SOR1. Possibly tomorrow. Oh, actually, no, tomorrow I'm doing Warzone with Jason Bradbury on his channel. And then Axel SOR1. And then we'll work through these guys. Apparently, Axel. You reckon? Well, I got told that Axel SOR1's meant to be quite OP, so he's meant to be quite easy. We'll see. I don't really like Axel as a player, but we'll give it a shot. So we've got Adam next time I play. And Axel, and then I think Max SOR2 is going to be quite easy. He's meant to be quite tricky, And also Axel SoR3's meant to be really crap. I'm not sure if that's true or not, but Blaze SoR3's meant to be really good. She's got a good run. Skate SoR3's meant to be OP. I reckon I'll be no problem with him. Same with him. And Shiva, I've done Mania with Shiva already. So I'll be okay with Shiva. It's just the SoR2 characters. These two, I think, are going to be the tricky ones. I think he's meant to be quite decent. Yeah. Right. I'll see you guys next time. Cheers for tuning in, everyone. See you tomorrow.